Hello students, so today we start with a new topic of motion in one dimension. All the problems related to it, that is the numerical part of motion in one dimension. There are problems in part A and part C. Part B is omitted. So in the part A, we are here to convert from kilometers per hour to meters per second, or vice versa. From meters per second, they will ask you to convert into kilometers per hour. Next, about the uniform speed. When it is uniform speed, we use a normal formula for speed, that is the speed is equals to distance upon time. In short, we write S is equals to D upon T. So if I want D, distance, I have to multiply speed into time. I want time, then I need to write distance upon speed. Then we studied about the acceleration. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time, that is V minus U upon T, where U stands for your initial velocity, V stands for your final velocity, and T is the time interval. So these are the things required in this chapter or this part of the numerical. So just write down on a paper and refer to it while solving the problems. Your first question, first numerical, says about speed of a car is already 72 kilometers per hour. We are supposed to get the answer in meters per second. A part, that is meters per second. How do we get in meters per second? So here the solution for it, I am trying to give you an easier method and also the reference material also. That is, if it is 72 kilometers per hour, yahan par per hour ka matlab hota hai upon hour, chalega? Per hour ka matlab hai upon hour. I am supposed to get converted this kilometer into meter. So when you want kilometer into meter, 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meters. Iske liye we multiply by 1000, and hours we want to convert into second. 1 hour is equals to 3600 seconds. So divide by 3600. Okay, in some other they give you a direct method. Don't look at this. See, a direct method would be into 5/18. Now where does this 5/18 come from? It comes from this only. How? 0000, 2 5s and 2 18s. So that is your 5/18. Samajh mein aa raha hai? So now if I go for cancellation, 18 18 1s and 18 4s, which gives me 18 1s, 18 4s, which gives me 5 2 4 5s 20. So this is converted into meters per second. Getting it? So speed has become 20 meters per second. You can use either 1000/3600, or if you want, you can directly use 5/18 for calculation purpose. Okay, both are similar, but don't get confused why it is used, ye kahan se aaya. This is your explanation for it. Okay, the second question is about express. The speed is given in 15 meters per second, and we are supposed to get converted into meters per kilometers per hour. So it will become reciprocal. So the speed, which was 15 meters per second, to get converted, we use 15 into 3600 upon 1000, or you can take 18 upon 5. Why? 0000, 2 5s and 2 18s, 5 1s, 5 3s. So what you are left is 3 into 18. 3 into 24 and 54. So your speed has become 54 kilometers per hour. Getting it? Simple calculation. Now in the third question, there are two parts. They have given express each of the following in meters per second. Your A part is, we want to get convert into meters per second. Your first part is 1 kilometers per hour. So here it is a simplified calculation which I showed you previously. 1 into kilometer is 1000 and hours is 3600. 1 into this will remain same, 0000, 2 5s and 2 18s. So you are left out with 5 upon 18. Divide this 5 upon 18, 5 inside and 18 outside. So it becomes 0.0, 0, 18. 2s are, it becomes 36, remaining is 4 and 1, 0, it comes out to be 7s are, and ultimately 8s are. So it is going to be 0.278 meters per second. So your speed gets converted to meters per second. So 1 kilometer per hour is actually 0.278 meters per second. The B part, it is 18 kilometers per minute. Here again I am converting, just to show you, 18, it is 18 kilometer upon minute. I want meters per second, so it is 18 into kilometer into meter is 1000 and minute into second, 1 minute is 60 seconds. So instead of minute, I am converting into second and putting it as 60. 0 and 0, 6 1s and 6 3s. So it comes out to be 300 meters per second. So this is your speed in meters per second. So 18 kilometers per minute has become 300 meters per second. Okay. The next question is your fourth question, where we are supposed to arrange. We are supposed to arrange in increasing order, that is your ascending order. Ascending order ka matlab hoga, start with the smallest speed, small, bigger and bigger. So here they have given three values, 10 meters per second, 1 kilometers per minute and 18 kilometers per hour. So we'll solve the three and make it into meters per second. How? Already the first one is 10 meters per second, so no need of solving it. The second part B is 1 kilometers per minute. So as I said just now, 1 into kilometer is 1000 upon minutes is seconds. So 0, 0, 2, 3s, 2, 50s. You are left with 50 upon 3 on division. 50 and 3. 3 1s are 3, 2, 0 left, 3 6s are 18, 2 left, 0.0, 6s are 18. Again it is going to get repeated, so it will be 66, something like that. So which is approximately 16.67 again meters per second. So this is your second value. Your first value is 10 meters per second. Second, converting into meters per second, it is 16.67. And your C part, that is your third part, is 18 kilometers per hour. So how do I convert this? It becomes 18 into 1000 upon 3600. Again 0000, 5s and 18s. So directly 18 and 18 cancels. You are left with 5 meters per second. Okay, so this is your third value. Now since after comparing, getting all the three in same unit, that is meters per second, we are supposed to arrange in increasing order. Increasing order ka matlab hoga, start with the smallest value. Smallest 10 hai, ye hai ya ye hai, ye hai, 5 hai, 5. So your 5 meters per second is sabse chota. Usse bada 5 se bada is 10. 10 meters per second, और उससे बड़ा इज दिस 16.67 meters per second. बट इसका एक्चुअल वैल्यू क्या था? एक्चुअल वैल्यू वॉज 18. तो इसका मतलब 18 किलोमीटर्स पर आर इज़ द स्मॉलेस्ट. उसके बाद में 10 मीटर्स पर सेकेंड वॉज गिवन एज इट इज़, तो उसको हम लोग एज इट इज़ रखेंगे. इज़ लेस देन दिस 16.67 विच इज़ एक्चुअली योर 1 किलोमीटर्स पर मिनट. सो दिस इज़ योर असेंडिंग ऑर्डर और इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर बाई फर्स्ट कन्वर्टिंग ऑल इंटू मीटर्स पर सेकेंड एंड देन पुटिंग अप द greater and smaller sign. Okay, the next question is your fifth question. Fifth question says a train takes 3 hours, that is the time taken. Fifth question. The time taken is 3 hours to go from Agra to Delhi with a uniform speed. The speed given is 65 kilometers per hour. So what is the distance between them? Distance between the two cities. So the solution says the distance ka formula was speed into time. The speed given is 65 and the time given is 3 hours. So directly to apply, 3 5s are 15, 3 6 are 18 and 19, 195. Distance is in kilometers. So your distance which was required, that is distance between the two cities, is 195 kilometers. Getting it? So the next question now, it is about the sixth question. Is about a car travels first 30 kilometers. So the first journey it covers a distance of 30 kilometers with a uniform speed of 60 kilometers per hour. And the next yani ke the second journey that is of 30 kilometers, again he covers 30 kilometers with again a uniform speed, but this time the speed is 40 kilometers per hour. Calculate the total time of the journey. We want the total time. Okay, we'll proceed. Let me take this as D1, S1, this as D2 and S2. So what will be the time T1 over here? What will be the T2 over here? So let me calculate it as T1, that is T1 is equals to distance upon speed, D1 upon S1. So your T1 will become, distance is 30 and time is 60. Sorry, your speed is 60. 0, 0, 3 1s and 3 2s. It becomes half, but half an R. Half an R means how much? Half into 60, multiply by 60, because I'm just showing where to show you, because 1 hour is equals to 60 minutes. So I'm converting into minutes. 2 ones are 2 30s. So the time taken for the first journey is 30 minutes. Getting it? So T1 hum log ne find out kar liya. On the other side, again T2 find out karna hai. So again T2 is equals to D2, distance 2 upon speed 2. Distance 2 is 30. And speed 2 is 40. So it is 0, 0 cancels. Left is 3 upon 4. But this is in your 3 upon 4. This is in hours. I want in minutes. So what I do is multiply by 60. 4 1s are 4, 15s are. 15 3s are is 45. So it becomes 45 minutes. So that is your T2. So by solving the two parts of the journey, by taking part 1 separately and part 2 separately, I have got two different time intervals. But your first question, the question in this was to find the total time of the journey. Therefore, the total time of journey will become your T1 plus T2. That is the first part timing plus the timing of the second part. That is 30 minutes plus 45 minutes, which comes out to be 75 minutes. Got it? See, here I have kept this in fraction. Why? Because I am going to use it ahead, because the second part of it is about find the average speed. Okay, now how do we find the average speed? Here I am putting up the average speed. The formula for average speed is the total distance covered upon the total time taken. Getting it? It is the total distance upon the total time. Total distance ka matlab hoga d1 plus d2, and total time ka matlab hoga t1 plus t2. d1 plus d2, what is your d1? D1 here it is 30, so 30 plus d2 here it is again 30, and t1, I'm not using minutes, I'm using hours. It is half an hour plus here 3/4 hours. Getting it? So how do I solve this? Because minutes mein solve karenge, so you will get the answer in kilometers per minutes mein answer milega. We don't want answer in this. We want either in kilometers per hour ya meters per second. Either of them mein hona chahiye. Yahan par it will be in kilometers per minutes. So iske liye I am using this fractional values, because they were in hours. So now this becomes 30 plus 30 is 60, and here the LCM part is multiplying by 2 and multiplying by 2. It becomes 2 plus 3/4, which is 60 into, this denominator goes up, into 4 upon me, 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 ones are 5, 12s are. So it becomes 12 into 4. That is 48 kilometers per hour. So this is your average speed. Getting it? By using two different datas, first journey, second journey, to get the total time and the total distance. So to using in average speed, total distance upon total time. And why I have used this fractional part? Because I want the answer in kilometers per hour, because yahan par maine already minutes mein convert kiya tha to give your answer in minutes, but yahan par to get the answer in hours, I am using this fraction of 3/4 and 1/2. Getting it? Just go through it properly. The next problem is your question number 7. Here it is said that a train is moving from, takes 2 hours to reach from B to A. The train moving from B to A, it takes 2 hours and then 3 hours while returning from A to B, it takes 3 hours. Lekin dekh rahe ho, B to A ya A to B, the distance remains the same. Yahan par distance kitna diya hai? The distance between the two stations is 200 kilometers. Okay. To yahan par, first of all, I mentioned that distance given is 200 kilometers. Chalega? Now here the time is 2 hours, and here the journey from B to A, and this is your journey from A to B. Distance is 200, distance here also is 200 kilometers. The time taken over here is, from B to A is 2 hours, and time taken over here is 3 hours. Getting it? So we want, what do we want is, first is the average speed. So your average speed, just now in the previous problem we used, average speed is equal to the total distance covered upon the total time taken. The total distance is your d1 plus d2, and total time is t1 plus t2. So let this be d1, t1, d2 and t2. So your d1 is 200 kilometers plus one more 200 kilometers upon t1 plus t2, that is 2 hours plus this 3 hours. So it becomes 200 plus 200 is 400 upon 2 plus 3 is 5. Cancellation, 5 8s are 40, therefore 80 kilometers per hour. So this is your average speed. Your average स्पीड फर्दर. एवरेज स्पीड के बाद व्हाट यू वांट इज एवरेज एवरेज वेलोसिटी ऑफ द ट्रेन. यू वांट एवरेज वेलोसिटी ऑफ द ट्रेन. नाउ फॉर द वेलोसिटी यू शुड रिमेंबर द कंसेप्ट दैट सिंस द ट्रेन इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम बी टू ए एंड अगेन फ्रॉम बी टू ए इट इज़ कमिंग बैक टू इट्स इनिशियल पोजिशन. Velocity, average velocity, when we are finding velocity, the word displacement comes into picture. Displacement. And what do you mean by displacement? The shortest distance between the initial and the final position. So here the initial and the final positions remain the same. Iska matlab yahan par velocity is zero. Velocity yani ke speed is zero. So as we just put up the statement, as the train from A to B, as the train travels from A to B and back from B to A, therefore we say that the displacement is zero. And when the displacement is zero, therefore your average velocity will also become zero. So just to put up the statement that since the displacement is zero, your average velocity is zero. Getting it? Next question is about a car moving with on a straight path covers a distance covered is 1 kilometer, but your 1 kilometer is about 1,000 meters due east in the direction east. Direction is mentioned over here, and it takes a time of 100 seconds. What is the speed? Therefore, what is the speed? And also they have asked what is the velocity. Now, what will be the difference between the speed and the velocity? While giving the answer for speed, you are just going to solve it and give the numerical value. But when it is velocity, you also have to mention the direction. Iske liye yahan par east specify kiya gaya hai. Okay? So let me solve it. Your A part, they want speed. The speed is equals to distance upon time. The distance is 1000 meters. Upon time is 100 seconds. 1212. Therefore, your speed is just 10 meters per second. So, ye mil gaya speed. Okay? But for the velocity, we have to mention B part, the velocity of the car. The velocity of the car is what? Is the same as the speed in magnitude. Magnitude means numerically it is equal magnitude, but along with direction. Along with direction. And therefore, the asked part was velocity. Therefore, the velocity of car will equal to the same answer, that is 10 meters per second. But in which direction? Due east. When you specify the direction, that means that is your velocity. Getting it? This is about the 8th question. The 9th question, now we start with those problems related to acceleration. Here a body starts from rest. See, pay attention. Whenever it is said that the body is at rest, you put u is equals to 0. Okay? Already at rest. And when it is said that comes to rest, we use v is equals to 0. Here initially the velocity was 0. And when it comes to rest, after applying some brake or something like that, then we use V is equals to 0. Here, this problem says a body starts from rest. So since it starts from rest, we use initial velocity as 0 meters per second. And acquires means it has a final velocity of 10 meters per second in time interval of 2 seconds. Then find its acceleration. A is the acceleration. So your simple solution formula for acceleration was V minus U upon T. Therefore acceleration is 10 minus 0 upon 2. That is acceleration is 10 upon 2, which is equals to 5. The unit for acceleration is meters per second square. Please don't make a mistake while writing the unit. It is 5 meters per second square. Got it? This was your 9th question. The next question is, the 10th question is about a car starting from rest. Again, it is starting from rest, means U is equals to 0 meters per second. It acquires a velocity, that is its final velocity becomes 180 meters per second. But in how much time? Time is 0.05 hours. See here, just for the confusion, they have provided R. We are supposed to give the answer in seconds. So convert this into seconds. How do we convert into seconds? But before that, when I shift the decimal, it becomes 5 upon 2 places on right hand side, means upon mein 100 aa jayega, into 3600, because 1 hour is equals to 3600 seconds. Getting it? 0 and 0 cancels. Multiplying it, 6 5 are 13, 3 and 80, 180 seconds. So time is 180 seconds. So now what you want is acceleration. Acceleration is how much? Therefore acceleration is equals to V minus U upon T. Your V is 180 minus U is 0 and T is already 180. So it comes out to be 180 upon 180. Cancel 1. So your acceleration is just 1 meter per second square. That is your answer in meters per second. Here in this problem, for the confusion sake, they had given the time in hours, so that we convert it first into seconds and then use the normal formula. Next question, 11th question. Here a body is moving vertically upwards. See here, listen carefully. Here the word rest is not mentioned. So the body is already moving. So a body is moving vertically upwards. Its velocity changes at a constant rate from it becomes from 50 meters per second, it changes to 20 meters per second. Iska matlab pehle itna tha, baad mein itna ho gaya. Obviously, remember the concept. When the body is moving in an upward direction, its velocity goes on decreasing. Matlab initially wo 50 pe tha aur baad mein uska 20 ho gaya. Jaise jaise wo upar gaya. Iska matlab ye ho gaya initial U aur ye ho gaya final V. So I put up here the data. U is 50 meters per second and V is 20 meters per second. Now what about the timing given? A body is moving vertically upwards, its velocity changes at a constant rate from 50 meters per second to 20 meters per second in time 3 seconds. So find the acceleration. Okay, let me see what it comes out to be. Acceleration ka formula was again V minus U upon T. That is A is equal to V is 20 minus U is 50 and T is 3. Therefore acceleration becomes 20 minus 50 is minus 30 upon 3. Therefore A is equals to minus 10 meters per second square. You are getting the answer in negative. Why? Because final velocity is less. So your negative sign will show that the velocity is decreasing. So, and such type of negative acceleration is called as, do you remember? It was called as deceleration or retardation. So here the negative sign indicates the decrease in velocity. decrease in velocity, and therefore we call it as retardation. That is, therefore A is equals to 10 meters per second square, that is your retardation is 10 meters per second square. Whenever you get a negative answer for A, it is called as retardation. Understood? Same problem, only the negative factor has come into picture. This negative factor means the velocity is decreasing, and since the velocity is decreasing, we call it as retardation. Next question is about a toy car. Question number, we have done up to, wait a minute, where am I? Okay, question number 12. The question number 12 says, a toy car initially it is moving with a uniform velocity. Initially means U. U is 18 kilometers per hour. 18 kilometers per hour. It is already moving with 18 kilometers per hour. So first I need to convert it. That is 18 into 5 upon 18. 18 cancels. It becomes 5 meters per second. So your initial velocity is 5 meters per second. And they have said in the problem that with a uniform velocity of 18 kilometers per hour comes to a stop. Remember, the word stop is used. Comes to stop means its final velocity becomes 0 meters per second. In how much time? In time 2 seconds. So find the retardation. They have already specified retardation. Iska matlab apna answer negative aana chahiye. So here the retardation solution, that is your A is equals to V minus U upon T. A is equals to V is 0 minus U is 5 upon T is 2. Therefore A is equals to minus 5 upon 2. Therefore A is equal to negative as it is minus 2 upon 5 ka half is 2.5. The unit is meters per second square. So we got the answer as 2.5 meters per second square. But to remove the negative sign, we just write it as retardation. Therefore your retardation is just 2.5 meters per second square. Got it? Same type of problem, but already specified that you are going to get a negative answer because they have mentioned in the question, find the retardation. Okay? And the conversion to get the answer in meters per second. The next question, 13th one, it is about a car accelerates at a rate of, accelerates means it is the acceleration is already given to you. Acceleration is already given to you. That is your A. Acceleration is already 5 meters per second square given to you. Find the increase in the velocity in 2 seconds. Time is given 2 seconds. So here 2 seconds. We want the increase or change in velocity. Increase in velocity is how much? While deriving the formula for acceleration, we had written that acceleration is equal to rate of change of velocity, that is change in velocity upon time. So when you multiply this with this, this change in velocity ka matlab hota hai increase in velocity. Therefore your increase in velocity is actually acceleration into time. The acceleration given to us is 5 meters per second square and time is given 2. Therefore your increase in velocity is 5 to the 10 meters per second square. Why meters per second square? Because it is about velocity. Therefore your answer is 10 meters per seconds. It is meters per second. It's velocity meters per second. Okay. The next question is the 14th question, where it is said a car is moving with a velocity of 20 meters per second. It is already moving. Remember, already moving. Okay, sorry, already moving. Matlab u is given 20 meters per second. And then the brakes are applied. Dekho, maine bataya tha, brakes are applied. Jab bhi brakes are applied, your final velocity will become 0 meters per second. Retards it at a rate of, retards matlab acceleration is 2 meters per second square. Then what will be the velocity after 5, what the time interval given is 5 seconds. So what will be its velocity? Velocity kitna hoga after applying the brakes after 5 seconds. So yahan par finally wo stop nahi ho raha hai, just brake apply kiya hai. To brake apply karne ke baad mein wo स्लो होते जाएगा और बाद में रुकेगा, बट एकदम 5 सेकंड्स में नहीं रुकने वाला है. तो 5 सेकंड्स में तभी उसका कुछ स्पीड होगा, डिक्रीज हुआ रहेगा. तो व्हाट इज़ दैट डिक्रीज्ड स्पीड, वो फाइंड आउट करेंगे. सो सॉल्यूशन इज अगेन ए इज इक्वल्स टू वी माइनस यू अपॉन टी. योर ए इज 2, वी इज डोंट नो, माइनस यू इज 20 एंड टी इज 5. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाइंग 5 टू जा 10 is equals to V minus 20. Taking this on this side, it becomes 10. Is it going properly? Meters per second. T is given 5. Okay. Since it is said to be retard, so we use it as negative. We use it as negative 2. So it becomes negative. So negative 20 on this side will give you plus 20 is equals to V, and therefore your V becomes 10 meters per second. Can you see the answer that initially it was 20 or after 5 seconds ke baad mein it has become 10? Kyun kam ho gaya? Initial se kam kyun answer aaya? Because it is retarding. Problem ke andar it is specified that there is retardation. Iske liye pehle se we have substituted negative value of A as minus 2. Getting it? Then you get a proper answer, 10 meters per second square. That is the negative sign, mention it, negative sign indicates that the velocity is decreasing. Getting it? Why I have used negative sign over here. Okay. Next is a similar problem, the 15th question, wherein a bicycle initially it is moving with 5 meters per second and accelerates for 5 seconds. Matlab time diya hai. Time is 5 seconds. At a rate of, matlab your acceleration is given. Just look at the unit, 2 meters per second square. Per second square aa gaya, matlab wo acceleration hai. Then find what is the final velocity. Final velocity is V. Simple question hai, simple substitution hai. That is, A is equals to V minus U upon T. A ka value is 2. V ka value we don't know. Minus U is 5. T is again 5. Cross multiply 5 to the 10 is equals to V minus 5. Change on, shift on the other side. 10 plus 5 is equals to V. That means your V has become 15 meters per second square. Abhi kuch log sochte hoge ki sir previous answer mein kam ho gaya tha, yahan par badh gaya. Kyun? Kyunki acceleration bola gaya hai, yahan par retardation nahi bola gaya hai. Retardation bola hota to answer kam aata, but yahan par acceleration hai, iske liye wo in comparison to u v hamesha zyada aayega, because it is acceleration. Got it? The 16th and the last question, what does it say? It's a lengthier one. 16th question says, a car is moving in a straight line with some speed. With some speed, matlab u, initially it is moving it with some speed of 18 kilometers per hour. So first we convert this into meters per second. So what I did, told you the shortcut, it was multiply by 5 upon 18. So it will get converted to meters per second. 18 cancel. So your u initial velocity is 5 meters per second. Further we read, aage bola gaya hai, it is stopped. stopped मतलब v has become 0 meters per second. Finally, it has stopped in time interval of 5 seconds by applying the brakes. देखो वापस से brakes आ गया और यहाँ पर specify किया गया है that it is stopped. इसके लिए हम लोग ने 0 use किया. Find the speed of the car. The first question. The speed of the car is equals to the distance upon time. Distance upon time. Already it was given in kilometers per hour. So the speed will be distance covered per time interval. But यहाँ पर already the distance covered तो ये final velocity ही हो जाएगा. The speed in meters per second is your initial velocity. Initially it was moving with 5, so it will continue to move with 5 meters per second. क्योंकि v तो finally 0 है, वो change नहीं हो रहा है. Such type of thing is called as uniform. Such is called as a uniform speed. Okay? So now, after this, we want retardation. Retardation yane A ka formula. A is equals to v minus u upon t. So A is equals to v is already 0, u is 5, and time interval given is again 5. So your acceleration becomes minus 5 upon 5. 5 cancels, therefore A is equal to minus 1 meters per second square. But minus 1, minus aa gaya matlab we are going to write it is retardation. Therefore, the retardation is equals to 1 meters per second square. Getting it? तो first पूछा था speed of the car in meters per second, हम लोग ने दे दिया. Second पूछा था retardation, yes we have showed it. The speed of the car after 2 seconds of applying the brake. मतलब अभी हम लोग time interval को, ये जो third part है, उसका डेटा थोड़ा चेंज हो जाएगा. दैट वी फाइंड आउट करना है. यू वॉज ऑलरेडी 5 मीटर्स पर सेकेंड, लेकिन टाइम अपने को कितना चाहिए? आफ्टर 2 सेकेंड्स. आफ्टर 2 सेकेंड्स, ब्रेक्स मारने के 2 सेकेंड्स के बाद उसका स्पीड कितना हो जाएगा, दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड. और एक्सेलरेशन तो ऑलरेडी अपने को नेगेटिव मिला है, माइनस 1 मीटर्स पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. सो अप्लाइंग द फॉर्मूला ए इज इक्वल्स टू वी माइनस यू अपॉन टी. Your acceleration is minus 1, we have to find out, u is 5 and t is 2, cross multiply 2 ones are 2, lekin minus 2 is equal to v minus 5, minus 5 ko idhar le lenge, minus 2 plus 5 is equals to v, therefore your v becomes 3 meters per second. So this is your velocity after 2 seconds, is it? After 2 seconds the velocity becomes 3 meters per second. Second. So there were three parts in this. Initially we were using time interval as 5 seconds to find the first and the second part. For the third part the question has completely changed. Pura time taken was 5 seconds, but apne ko pura 5 seconds ka nahi chahiye. 1 2 3 4 5 seconds mein to wo stop ho gaya tha, lekin 2 seconds jab tha tab uska speed kya ho gaya. इसके लिए वी आर फाइंडिंग वी एट दिस पोजिशन. यू अपने को दिया गया है और इसमें अपने को 2 सेकेंड्स लगा एंड एक्सेलरेशन इज ऑलरेडी माइनस 1. तो अप्लाइंग ऑल दिस वी गेट द आंसर एज 3 मीटर्स पर सेकेंड. गेटिंग इट? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर पार्ट ए ऑफ मोशन इन वन डायमेंशन.